The average person is likely to be impacted by over 20 data breaches in their lifetime, but you can beat those odds right now by using a password manager. When used correctly, they can prevent you from having your identity stolen, protect you from all kinds of hacks, but more importantly, simplify your life and make it easier to have strong security. Today, I'll cover four of the best password managers for your security, two honorable mentions, and five pro tips at the end to maximize your security. All after a quick message from our sponsor. If you care about safe, secure password managers, then you're probably doing your due diligence across other services you use. The sponsor of this video might appeal to you because it's Notesnook. They are open source, end-to-end encrypted, and actually implement a lot of the security that you see covered for these password managers, but instead for your ideas, thoughts, and notes that you store online. The way it works is it encrypts the data on your device, and by the time it reaches their servers, they're not able to access any of it because it's done with your encryption keys. If you have another device on your Notesnook account, only you're ever able to see your data, and that's because it's end-to-end encrypted. It's not just secure though. When you compare the feature set to other even mainstream services out there, you'll see that it's extremely competitive, and they have some fantastic ways of organizing your life and getting more productive and organized. Check out Notesnook down in the description. They're completely free to try and they are open source, and you can verify everything they do is what they say it is. And now back to the top password managers. I see people ask, why a password manager? Isn't it just storing everything in one place? Actually, it's more secure. Password managers use strong encryption to protect your data, making it far more difficult for hackers to access compared to reusing weak passwords across multiple accounts. Plus, they encourage the use of unique, complex passwords for each site, significantly reducing your risk of compromise even if one site is breached. Number four is 1Password. 1Password is probably the most popular option on this list. It's mainstream, has an excellent security team with a great audit history. They were one of the first password managers to release passkey support and an approachable user interface with great cross-platform support. It's truly designed for almost anyone to use with a large degree of security, hence why they're well known for having a great family plan. Cons: 1Password offers a free trial, but it requires a paid subscription for continued use. The more important con is it's the only password manager on our list that is not open source. That's a big ding for some people. While 1Password implements some industry-leading security practices, it's hard to rank them higher when the other options that we're going to cover today put their code on full display for the community to verify it. Overall, it's just a great service you can't go wrong with unless you're someone who exclusively wants something open source. Number three is Bitwarden, a huge favorite in the open source community, so I'm excited to cover it. Bitwarden has one of the most generous free plans for a cloud-based password manager, and it's all open source with excellent cross-platform support. They are audited, support passkeys, and implement top-notch security practices, and if you upgrade, they have one of the most affordable subscriptions I've quite literally ever seen. It's pretty commendable. If you're a savvier user, you can actually self-host Bitwarden, which puts you in complete control of your data. The cons of Bitwarden are its free plan has some limitations compared to premium, but in my opinion, the biggest con of Bitwarden is usability. Many users find Bitwarden's interface less intuitive and dated than 1Password. This is personal preference, and given Bitwarden's free plan, I would almost universally encourage people to try Bitwarden first to see if it works for them before deciding to lock in 1Password. That's what I personally recommend to people I know, and I think it makes a lot of sense. Ultimately, people in the privacy community adore Bitwarden, and it's been a favorite for a long time that countless people rely on. Number two is new to the list, and it's Proton Pass, and it's also the password manager that I personally use. Proton Pass is open source and part of the Proton ecosystem, creators of Proton Mail, so it's hard to justify a different password manager when Proton Pass is already free if you're a paying Proton subscriber. Proton Pass also gives 1Password a real run for its money in offering an incredibly usable UI UX. Many people like how it's from a reputable company with a great track record for security. It's cross-platform, supports passkeys, and the highlight feature is its direct integration with simple login email aliasing for people who want to generate emails for every account. Bitwarden has a similar feature, but it's a little bit more direct when it's from Proton, who also owns simple login. The cons are Proton Pass is newer to the market and still developing its features, though they've been developing crazy fast. I went from being pretty critical of the service to actually using the service in about a year's time. The other major con is Proton Pass has the biggest risk of lock-in because of its email integration with Simple Login, which granted you don't need to use, but if you do, it makes it extremely hard to ever justify leaving the Proton ecosystem, which in some ways almost speaks to just how great this integration truly is, because otherwise you wouldn't feel like you couldn't leave it. To bring it together, Proton Pass is a fantastic password manager, the one I'm personally using, and is a great balance of security, usability, and cost. Now, before sharing number one, I have two quick honorable mentions. While seemingly simple, relying solely on pen and paper for password management has big drawbacks. It limits password complexity, manually entering passwords is time-consuming and prone to errors. Additionally, a physical notepad poses a security risk if lost or stolen, potentially exposing all of your account credentials. However, it's an honorable mention as it's an alternative for those who, for one reason or another, aren't able to use a password manager. If you're forced to use pen and paper, make sure to be more cryptic so that if someone finds it, it's not just a basic list of your accounts and their respective passwords. The second honorable mention is Apple Passwords. Previously, Apple only let you save passwords on Apple devices via keychain. They have since slightly expanded this to their new password manager by including support for Windows with browser extensions, and now it's a dedicated program which functions as more of an actual password manager. However, it still lacks the robust cross-platform support and advanced features offered by the dedicated password managers like 1Password, Bitwarden, and Proton Pass. You should almost always look at the other options first. They're just kind of better. And finally, our number one password manager of 2025 is familiar and our prior winner, KeePass. KeePass is open source, offline by default, and a bit different from the others on the list. While the others set everything up for you and use a traditional account-based setup, KeePass puts you completely in the driver's seat. Your KeePass life exists in this database file, which is just an encrypted file, which gives you the most ownership, control, flexibility, and in many ways, security. The main downside to KeePass is inherent to its flexibility, which is there's a variety and quality of clients. We do recommend KeePass XE for Windows and Linux, Strongbox for macOS and iOS, and KeePass DX for Android. Those are my favorite clients, but you'll have to experiment to find your favorites. Speaking to this variety, KeePass may have complete, limited, or no direct support for passkeys depending on the client that you choose. So pick a client you enjoy and make sure it has the features you want, or else you're gonna have a bad time. Second issue with KeePass is the issue of syncing. If you use Strongbox for Apple devices, it can sync on your local network. You can replicate this with any KeePass clients yourself with something like SyncThing, or you always have the option to just use a cloud provider to sync your database file between devices. In short, KeePass is probably the most robust offering on this list. Best for tech-savvy users, but it lacks some of the nice-to-haves of other password managers, like a unified interface, a central ecosystem, universally reliable browser extensions, and direct integration with other services like email aliasing. But it's also undeniably the most flexible and powerful on this list. Now, as promised, no matter which password manager you pick, here are five super quick tips to maximize your password manager. First, keep backups. If you lose access to your account or your database, what do you do? Make sure you implement a safe backup system and your future self will thank you. Second, use a unique master password. The password you use to get into your account is incredibly important, so it should be unique, new, and not used for anything else. Protect this well. Third, use 2FA to lock down your password manager. Whether you use an authenticator app or a security key, 2FA will go far in keeping your password manager more secure. Four, actually use and take advantage of your password manager's password generator. Don't just copy and paste your old passwords into your password manager without generating better ones. Also, many of the password managers today have tools to help you stay safer online, so actually utilize them. And fifth, set a limited timeout. You don't want your password manager to be unlocked all day. I would recommend keeping it under 5 minutes as a max. And with all of that said, those are the four best password managers. We filtered out companies that had glaring security incidents or over-prioritized marketing without enough of a commitment to user security. We also prioritized open source, with the one exception being 1Password. At the end of the day though, the most important thing is to choose a password manager and use it consistently. Don't delay your digital security. Just start using a password manager today to simplify your life, enhance your online security, and regain peace of mind. And if you're on the fence, every option today includes either a free trial or a free plan. So there's no risk in finding the best one for you. We'll leave links below to each service. A couple are optional kickback links that support the channel, but there's also standard links if you want to use those instead. I want to thank our sponsor, Notesnook, and all of our supporters who make this content possible. For more tech tips, reviews, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to check out our video on why I use a hardware security key for 2FA. Those are for your security nerds. See you next time on TechLore.